been a lot happening and a lot of exciting things. I'm going to see if I can do this with practice. So I think I can share my screen because I think that pictures will say way more than I will. So can you see that?
Mm-hmm. That's so awesome. Yeah.
Yeah. So basically, this is the most recent progress on our building. The part that's kind of covered up, the big white rectangle that you see, is our kindergarten first grade wing that they're going to finish up. So they've got really the outline of it down. They're allowing us to go each month and kind of walk through and take a sneak peek. So our PE teacher, Coach Lewis, has been making some videos for us to share with staff and with students. And we've shared that out to our families as well, just to get excited, because once these walls and roofs have started to go up, it's kind of hard to know what's happening. Mm-hmm. But it has been amazing progress, and it's really neat to see that we're going to have a school. This school is pretty standard size, and it's dwarfing our current existing building. Mm-hmm. So it is really happening, and it's been really speeding up pretty quickly now they've gotten a lot of the foundation down. So it's going well.
That's awesome. Now, just in case people don't know, what's the targeted finish up date and you all begin actually getting to use the school?
Yeah, they say that they will be finished constructing the new building by the end of May of this next year, so 2022, and that we would start moving in over the summer and be able to open up the new school year 2022-2023 in our new building. But then they would do the demolition of the existing building throughout the summer and into, I believe, as late as September of 2022. So we'll be in there next school year, but we won't really have access to our whole campus again until probably about October. We were just talking the other day about how it's pretty crazy to think we're going into 2022, and I don't know that we have fully processed 2020.
Right.
2021 is kind of dragged on and blown by at the same rate. But it has been a really good semester for us. As far as highlights, we're seeing that our students and staff and our families have just been amazing, rolling with things as they change from day to day. We do still have some safety procedures in place, and we have, knock on wood, stayed fairly healthy as a school and as a staff. But having to navigate some of the mandate that was put in place for us with masks kind of after the year had started threw us for a loop. And it was tough for some of our families, and we had to work through quite a lot. But I have to say that I'm very proud of the fact that, you know, on whatever side of issues that our families fall, we were stayed in good communication, worked through that. I'm very thankful for that our families trust us enough to bring us even their most delicate problems to help kind of work through that. So it was tough for us in October. That was a hard month. But we've kind of come back after fall break on the other side of that and have some really good relationships. I think it's when you go through those tough things, one of the wonderful silver linings is that it can bring you closer together. Mm-hmm. And thankfully, that's kind of been the case for us. And we have really seen with the consistency that we've had with school this semester that our students have made great progress. We are getting ready to celebrate some of that. Our first semester, we're seeing some great gains in a lot of areas academically. And we've been focusing a lot on this idea we're calling ready to learn. Like, what do I need in order to be ready to learn today, to try and help our students see sort of, what do you need beyond these walls? Like, what do you need in any situation to be ready to get whatever information that you're about to get? So there's been some big topics we've been teaching to our little ones lately. And I've just been very proud of how the community has really kind of come together, even though we still, I think, are in a lot of delicate places emotionally. It's been a word that's popped up a lot is we're really starting to see resiliency developing among our students. We have learned a lot from them over these last 3 years. And really, I had a conversation with our fifth graders that were like, think about how the last 3 years of school have been for you. I mean, you had a year that didn't really ever end. So you had half of a grade level, and then a year that was some online and some in person and some both at the same time. And now we're at this year. And they're like, I know, it's been weird. But they have handled it so well. I mean, there's things we got to work through. You can tell there's emotions and feelings that are bigger than their age, and they don't quite know how to express that. Like, I'm not feeling like myself right now and I don't know why. Mm-hmm. But it has been a really amazing opportunity for us to develop what we're calling being a safe and loved practice. So it's basically trauma-informed mm-hmm. learning and instruction, but we call it safe and loved, because if you don't feel safe and you don't feel loved, no learning is going to happen. Mm-hmm. So COVID has taught us a lot. And one of the things is that we've got to make sure that we're all taken care of before we expect any learning and any kind of progress to take place. It's really interesting that you say that. And I love that that's y'all's focus, because Emmanuel has been a word that I've been focusing on through Advent, and what exactly does that mean? And I think that it has allowed me to be able to lead in this position with as much grace as possible, because there are situations at like the height of the frustration of the major changes that the district went through in October was a very trying time. And there were moments where I was like, I don't have any patience left. I don't have any grace left. I don't have name a fruit of the spirit and it's gone right now. But I was able to remember that we can draw on a source that never runs out. And as cliche as that might sound, it was very real for me in the kind of beginnings of this semester, transitioning back. Like, how can you be in a position where people look to you to, like, are you going to keep us safe? Are we okay? What's next? Having to lead people, lead adults and children through what still feels a bit uncertain, I feel like for me, can really only come from the fact that I have that firm foundation and knowing that God is with me through that, that even if I take a wrong turn, He can redeem that to be a right one in the end. So it has been, it's been the foundation of leadership for me, especially in the last year and a half. First of all, thank you. Thank you for the support. I was just talking with Angie Cox, with my assistant principal, about how we work hard within these walls, but without the support of our families and our community, we can't help these students grow to be successful. So thank you for your support. I know that people have a lot of feelings toward public education right now, and we just appreciate that our community has continued to be supportive of us, because we need you. I guess that's my first thing that I would say, is not just Adrian Burnett, but the schools in your community, they need you. They need to know that you care. A kind word truly, really does go a long way. Thank you to The Grove for your ways that you just let our staff know they're being prayed for and loved. I think that would be my biggest thing to say moving into this break, just please to pray for our staff that they do get rest. It has been emotionally and physically and mentally tough for them to be the rock that our students need right now. So I would just ask for prayer for rest for them. And then also just continued progress, that we can really balance the urgency of kind of reclaiming some lost progress, but also supporting our students where they need it the most. That's a hard balance to strike, and it needs adults that have had the opportunity to take care of themselves too. So I just, taking care of our people, and honestly, I would just ask the community, just let your local school in your community know that they are loved. I'll say it again, the growth has been amazing for us. I actually just came up from enjoying a lovely breakfast that you all provided for us today. And your cards that say such kind words, it means a lot to our staff. And really, I think that the community support is what keeps us going. So as we move into our new building, we're hoping to have a building on the outside that matches how amazing the staff and students are on the inside. And your continued support really makes us start to believe that we can do big things.